Hey guys, what's going on? Duke here, and today I'm doing another BTD6 video. This time it's on Boomerang Monkey. As you can see, I've got all three paths fully unlocked. I'm currently working on the bomb shooter. I think I've done. Like, these are the ones I have to do. On that one. So, yeah, let's talk about the Boomerang Monkey. The Boomerang Monkey is, sorry about the noise, is a hurls boomerangs that follow a curved path, good range, and piss. So, the first path is Glaive Lord. Glaive Lord surrounds itself in three special glaives that shred anything that comes near. And then it also has the powers of more glaives. Multiple objects advanced ricochet greatly enhances the already extraordinary power of the Glaive Ricochet Monkey. Glaive Ricochet. Glaives will bounce and from bloom to bloom automatically and aggressively. And then middle path, Permacharge. This is the ability. Permacharge is permanently super fast. Sorry about the echo. Permanently super fast and has its ability increases its lethality more. Permacharge is a permanent version of Turbocharge. Turbocharge ability makes Monkey attack incredibly fast for 30 seconds, or 10 seconds. Morog Domination. Special knockback kindly triggers more often and do lots of extra damage. From that we have to go back to the Morog Press. Which heavy tiny boomerangs hit Morog class balloons multiple times per throw and sometimes knocks them back a short way along the path. But if you're wondering what Kylie style is, this is it. Throw Kylie heavy tiny boomerangs that follow a straight path instead of a curved. That's interesting. So we're going to do our normal map, which is Monkey Meadow. I just failed with the bombs on this map, because they can't hit black or zebra, and it's flipping expensive to get an MIB. So yeah, not fun. Anyway, I'm going to pick our first boomer, and let's go. No copyright stuff. So. So we have to save up for 1,000 so we can get the first monkey village. Obviously we are gonna go monkey training because this can pop any types of balloons apart from camo. So yeah. We also do have our farmers behind our camera. Ooh, monkeys already starting to have a little bit of problems. Looks like we're gonna have to put faster rounds, faster throwing. So we're gonna have 220 boomerang monkey. Here we go. This will now at least carry us to round 12. we're going to do every tower in the game apart from this one and this one. We're going to do Spike Factory and Monkey Engineer, as you can see. I've already got all three. Like, I've got all three full paths of these ports, but there's two sweet you get into magic. Superstorm, got Avatar Wrath. I haven't got Spirit of the Forest. So now we're just doing this. I'll come back to you guys when there's some stuff happening. And we're back on round 21. So as you see, I've got three banana farms, monkey farmer, and a village. And I'm still losing mana shield. After this I'm going to be at 6 mana shield. Yep, there you go. Right, Benjamin. We're gonna be losing permanent health. No. Oh, yikes. Also, I'm on a different phone, so for flagging, I'm very sorry. So my phone just heavily lagged on me. Still heavily lagging on me. Okay, so we're gonna have some light coming up soon-ish. So we're gonna need to get that eye popping power. Oh, there's the camera. Just breezes through twice. So don't mind me coming through. Right, all we need is 1,700, and then we can go top half. And there it is, round 28, first land round. Alright, what can we get? Actually, I need to sell this one. Off from there. Okay, for all tier 3 variants, that should last us for a little while. Now, let's start upgrading our banana farms. Actually, you guys can come back. I'll come back to you guys on round 40 when the Moab appears. And we're back at the tail end of round 39. As you can see, we've got Moab Press. All of my farms ready. activate the ability, and complete DZ mode. Mike Spike. Okay, now all my farms are upgraded. I find that banana plantation that's a tier 3 is really annoying, because in the other games it was a tier 2. So that really annoyed me. Primary training. All primaries get extra range. Primary mentoring. All primaries get tier 1 upgrade for free. Don't forget how we do here, we always have a opposite path variant of these towers. So, bottom half there, you went top half, so you'll go middle half. Then here we go. Live ricochet. And the cool thing is, it's all, they're all inside of primary rendering. So there we go. Got all the mirrors. Comment down below which path variants you like most. I'll use your favourites in a finale video of standalone towers. So, 3k in the bank, I'm a clone. Doing quite well. Oops, that's not what I meant to press. Making sure. Alright, we're at 12 minutes. We've got 3k in the bank. Well, on us. We can not get anything. I mean, we could get more glaives. And now turbocharge. We're gonna get two more glaives about now. Next upgrade for them is Glaive Lord. Pull out the money. Now we've got two turbocharge. And these are all tier 4s now. So this is the most accurate I'm going to get for you guys. Because I can only have one tier 5. I might live stream this one day. So you guys can pick the tier 5s. Got 8k. I'm gonna get Central Marketplace over with my brother. Mo, I've got Dare Mode. Also, if you're wondering why the echo, I'm in my room recording this time. Last time I was outside walking the dog, this time I'm inside recording. Oh, that Moab rest is so OP.
Oh god.
Oh, give me the Jesus. Wow, there's... They're getting destroyed out there.
Okay.
This is also the fourth cheapest tower in the game, tied with the monkey sub.
So,
yeah. I think we'll go bottom half for all of them. Because these all come from something and they all have blades. But these ones, they all pretty much have red hot wings. These two streets were fine, okay. Like, none of which ones can we buy? None of them. Okay, so this makes sense. Bottom route, cheapest overall. Middle route, the most overpowered, cheapest. Then glaive vault, second most overpowered, and then least overpowered. Bottom par, 51k. Because that makes sense. Bro, that's just too OP.
Okay.
Get monkey research facility. I want that monkey skimming ability. So I've been fun, so that's it. I mean, this is quite easy to do. Oh great, got that glitch again. So, I think it's because the latest update. Everyone's getting the money glitch with the bank. As in you can't pull out, and here is round 60. And there goes turbo speed, turbo charge. Yeah. Tired. These two fives are actually quite expensive. So it looks like we're gonna have to go over what we planned. First time I'm in perma charge.
What?
So, perma charge OP? I mean, you don't give me an F. That you can't pop legs, he's like, I'm still going for it anyway. Yeah. That's a few blow-ups. Okay, so we've got the siphon level. Right, this one's Glaive Lord. This one's Mora Bomb. I'll catch up with you guys in a minute. So we are back, and we can afford Glaive Lord. Cool. I think we should sell, like, the lower ones. Glaive Lord's glaives just go really fast, really quick. I think they go faster the more money we have. Hold on. I don't know. Comment down below if you know why these glaives are getting faster. Or slower. So I've just noticed he's the only one with red hot ranks. So he's a lead popper. Oh, also use. Can't believe I almost sold that guy. Ah. Wait, no, he's a lead popper as well. I'm a dumbass. Look how he's so slow in there. The closer it gets, it just speeds up. Wow. That should have been a BFB, so it should have that. This is too OP. So I can either get Moab Dom or Monkey Wall Street. Actually, if I get that, do that, sell that, and sell that. There we go. All tier fives. What is that AoE for the Moab Dom? Right. I will always get all three tier 5s at least by the end of round 80. Or I will keep going in. Huh? Oh god. Until I get them. So I hope you're enjoying the day. What is that AoE? Yeah. Okay, so monkey expertise. Okay. One shot Moabs, three shots BFBs. Bro, this thing's basically a glaive lord now. I'll meet you back on round 80, which is the final round. Press the wrong button again. And here is round 80. Don't tell me that thing's gonna five shot.
Bro, this thing's gonna five shot a ZOMG. Last shot.
Okay, so six shot. Yeah, I'm doing this as a standalone tower. And that is game. So,
oh god, wait.
I hope you guys have enjoyed. If you have, hit that like button down below. Subscribe if you're new. Don't forget to join the Discord. Guess that little tune that I'm making. Hold on. Okay, now I'm just doing dumb shit. Also, say your favourite tier 3 in the comments. And I might put him as a standalone tower. Well, no matter what, Permacharger is going to be a standalone. But you guys can also pick Glaive Lord and Moab Domination as a standalone tower. I'll even let you do that on the Dark Monkey. Actually, any tower you want will be standalone, but there is always going to be one auto standalone that I will pick, and that is Crossbow Master and Permacharge. This one I don't know yet. I think it might be Bomblitz, but Tax Zone definitely. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.